Hop in, babe, we're going.
Woohoo!
Well, your new friends from the Netherlands used to have a house left into the mud, but an old RV called Penelope, she's a 1983. Pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves Rob until the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe. Please subscribe. Hey, hello, everyone.
Good day.
So we need your advice on something.
Yes.
And we really need everyone's input on this one. Because this is like a
major decision.
A major decision. It's like a mind twister.
Wow.
So we, as you guys know, we've been looking bottom of the barrel for another camper van. Mm. And we've showed you that there are actually pretty decent camper vans for sale under 5,000 euro. Bottom of the barrel.
Yes.
Now we don't have the money in the high end of that 4,000-5,000 range are the best campers, of course. And we don't have 4,000-5,000 euros. So every time we saw a nice one, we couldn't go and get it because we don't have the cash in our pockets. So I saw there was a motorhome that we really liked, and it said in the description, it said, if you really like this motorhome, but you cannot afford it in one setting, we offer financing for the motorhome.
Yes.
And then I was looking at other motorhomes we liked from the dealerships, and they all offer financing. Every dealership, almost, not all of them, but...
No.
A few dealerships are connected to finance companies, and these finance companies, they offer you a sort of a micro loan on a 4,000-5,000 euro motorhome, and it would mean that for like a period of 5 to 6 or 7 or 8 or 10 years, we would have to pay a monthly amount back, and those monthly amounts, they vary roughly between 60 and 80 euros. So 60 to 80 euros per month would get us another motorhome. So what are we waiting for? Let's go get one.
Well, first of all, we don't know whether they will give a microloan to people in our situation. So there's one thing. And another disadvantage, of course, is when your camper gets stolen or breaks down or needs to be fixed, you still have to pay off the loan for so many years.
Yeah, you're committed to the loan for like, say, 6 years or more. But you don't know if you'll have the camper for 6 years or more.
No.
You could only have the camper of like for half a year and then pay it off for 6 years. And that is kind of a risky decision in that sense. We could get lucky. I mean, with this camper van, we were very lucky, but we paid this one cash in our pockets. So no loans. But now we are in a different situation. We have a time window that we have to find a new camper van in.
Deadline.
A deadline. Many campers will go into storage from next month and onwards. And so there will be less supply in that price range. We already see less supply. So a lot of motorhomes being sold right now. So we have to kind of get one now. We know we're not going to be able to secure the cash ourselves. So is financing an option? We know the risk is that if it goes wrong, we're increasing our monthly costs for many years if we do this.
Yes.
Maybe you're able to pay off the loan faster if you get the money faster in the future.
But yeah, that's all, of course, a moment in time. I mean, if Patrick finds something tomorrow or I find something tomorrow,
yeah,
trouble's over.
Trouble's over. We can pay that loan off very fast.
It's just, it's but sad, but true.
It would buy us more time. But we would have to have luck on our side. We would have to have the luck that if we get a loan for a 5,000 euro camper van,
Lady Luck has
that,
to,
that if we would drive it for the winter to Portugal, I mean, when you go drive it to Portugal, you're really going to get to know your camper van. And you're going to know this very soon if you bought a good one or a not so good one. And there might be some repairs coming, but we cannot prep for all kind of what if scenarios.
No.
So
that's what life is about. You can never prep for what if.
Yeah, I mean, many people in their 20s and 30s, they on two incomes, and the job that they have at that time, they get a mortgage based on two incomes that they say to the bank, for the rest of my life, I'm committing to paying off this huge mortgage. And that's way more invasive in your life and a big burden on your freedom. And it will prevent you from saying to your boss, I'm going to quit. I quit. I hate you. I quit. So it's a huge commitment. A mortgage is a huge commitment. A mortgage on a car, not so much commitment, but still risky.
Yeah.
I mean, there are people, they lose their jobs both, they lose their income, the bank, they cannot pay the mortgage, the bank...
they take the car.
Takes the car, takes your house, you end up with a debt, and you're depressed all your life. With the car, not so much, but it could still have a huge effect on us if we decide to take a loan. We don't know if they were gonna accept us for a micro loan. We don't know even, but we're in that pre-stage that we're saying,
it's
should we consider
option.
This as an option?
Yeah.
Knowing fully well, I mean, we're smart people, we know the disadvantages, we know the downsides, but it is an option.
Yeah, it is.
So throwing it out there and let us know what you think, because it's really, I mean, maybe you know something we don't, and you can help us
enlighten us,
make the decision easier, or make it easier not to go that route. The most ideal would be a loan from a private person. A private person you can say with, hey, if you're not going to be able to pay me this month, just pay me the next one. Or a private person could say, you know what, I'll upfront you the money now and just pay me back once you have your financial situation settled in or figured out. But a loan company will also charge you interest. They will say, I'm gonna loan you five, but you have to pay me back
six,
pay me big, pay me back six. So that's another thing. If you loan five, you have to pay back six. If you loan four, you have to pay back five with interest,
etc.
And so a lot of thinking to do. And that's why we ask you guys for advice. And we have asked you guys for support, and now we're asking you for advice. So please advise us in the comments. Everybody can comment. We unblocked everybody. So let us know what you think. And we really hope to hear from you, because that can decide or affect our decision to go for financing or not.
Yes. And thank you for doing it. If you are going to.
Yeah.
Yeah. thank you for watching, and thank you in advance for advice.
Yeah. See you in the next one.
If you like our videos, support us on Patreon or Tippy. But you can also make a one-time donation on PayPal or Ideal.
And if you read the description under the video, you'll find links to the book that we wrote about van life. It's called Help, My Man Wants to Live in a Van. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And you'll also find 4 photo books that we created.
And if you check out those links, you can also find our free ebook,
which you can download completely for free.